We want to get right to that hurricane watch. It's happening on the Gulf Coast. Take a look at this image from NASA. That is Tropical Storm Harvey from space. It's massive.
And it is gaining strength right now. Evacuations underway in some parts of Texas. People are preparing for the worst. They're stocking up on supplies. We want to go right to Ginger. She's tracking the storm. Good morning, Ginger.
George, they are right to prepare for the worst because this will be a heavy rain event and flooding that could impact life and property. We could lose both this weekend. Let me take you to Tropical Storm Harvey that formed overnight or redeveloped, and you can see it's about 300 miles south and east of Brownsville. Max sustained winds right now 45 miles per hour, moving north at 10 miles per hour. There are hurricane watches, tropical storm warnings, and a hurricane warning for a large area in southeast Texas, but this flood watch extends all the way to San Antonio for up to 20 inches of rain. We've got to get to the track in just a couple of moments, but first, our Matt Gutman already standing in water this morning in Corpus Christi. Matt?
Hey, good morning, Ginger. You're right. Water is the major story here. Now, check this out. The water here off of Corpus Christi is like a bathtub, 87 degrees, which is great if you want to go swimming. Very bad for a storm. It's basically turbocharging Harvey. And all morning long, our phones have been buzzing with hurricane warnings. Texas is very much on its toes this morning.
This morning, Texas declaring a state of disaster with cities along a 600-mile stretch of the Gulf of Mexico bracing for catastrophic rainfall.
We need people to be aware.
Harvey churning towards the Texas Gulf Coast, upgraded to a tropical storm overnight. Major cities, including Houston and San Antonio, forecast for a deluge of over a foot of rain from this storm, plus potentially devastating storm surge.
We're going to have coastal flooding.
All of our bayous and creeks would be potentially a problem with this type of rainfall.
Residents in the Lone Star State emptying shelves, many stores selling out of basics, including water.
Some of the essentials.
Water and food and batteries.
Just getting ready for it.
City officials and emergency responders preparing for the worst this morning. Local law enforcement practicing for potential helicopter rescues. College campuses under mandatory evacuations. And drivers warned to avoid the roads as main thoroughfares are shut down.
Now, 12,000 students could potentially be locked out of the local university here. There's sandbagging operations all over this town, and there's concern as far away as New Orleans, 550 miles away, that the pumps there won't be able to handle that massive deluge. Ginger.
Matt, thank you. So much to talk about here, but we have to go to the track and the timing. I know that's important to everyone. So as it gets going the next 24 hours, we should see this become a hurricane, a category one. It makes landfall sometime early Saturday morning, just south of Corpus Christi in this latest track. Then it sits around, and that's going to be the problem. It does not move much, and that's where you're going to end up getting significant rainfall. Some of the warnings have up to 25 inches locally, a wide swath of 8 to 15 inches. And you can see it goes all the way, as Matt was saying, up through Louisiana. Storm surge 2 to 7 feet, huge waves that we will talk about in just a bit. And guys, this is going to be a big storm, not just because of the storm surge, but because of that rain, much like Tropical Storm Allison. Look at these images from 2001. This was only, in quotes, a tropical storm. But if we remember, there were $5 billion in damage, more than 20 people dead, 30,000 homes in Houston lost because of the rain.
Yesterday, its remnants were over the Yucatan Peninsula. Now it's in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico, an area that's ripe for the production of tropical systems. That's what we're seeing. It's already a tropical depression again as of the 11 a.m. update from the National Hurricane Center. The hurricane hunters found a renewed center of circulation, and it's forecast to intensify as it heads towards the Texas Gulf Coast. The issue is what happens when it gets there. You notice the forecast track. It just starts crawling along the Gulf Coast as it runs into high pressure to the north as a high-end tropical storm, producing very heavy rainfall and a forecast storm surge possibly up to 4 to 6 feet. With that, we'll see heavy rainfall stretching from Corpus Christi through the Houston area, western parts of Louisiana, 10 to 15 inches of rainfall forecast right now with local amounts up to around 20 inches. So a big time flooding event possible as we head into the weekend. For parts of the Gulf Coast, our area will feature some heavier rainfall at times thanks to this tropical wave. It does have a 30% chance of development, but that would likely happen once it moves off Florida's east coast. A northeasterly track from there prevents any major impacts with us. But as I mentioned, we will see some enhanced rain chances over the next few days. Not so much this afternoon, about a 30% rain chance. Those showers and thunderstorms that I mentioned drifting westward towards the coast. But as we head into the day tomorrow with better moisture above us, you'll notice a better coverage of some showers and thunderstorms, some of those thunderstorms producing some locally heavy rainfall tomorrow afternoon. And you can expect a similar setup for Friday into the early part of the weekend.
So let's first go into the tropics. We'll talk about two areas. One, I want to get out of the way. It's not going to affect us, but just in case you have interest in Texas, we have the remnants of what used to be Tropical Storm Harvey in the Gulf. It's reemerged, and it has basically a guaranteed shot at becoming Tropical Storm Harvey once again. All the models are taking it right into eastern Texas, so this will be something to watch. And if you have any family, friends, or interest there, obviously this would be a concern to you, but this is not expected to affect us. So that's Harvey, or the remnants of it. Then we also have a tropical wave, which doesn't look like much, but it's this moisture you see around the state right now, and it's helping to increase the amount of rain, or really the amount of atmospheric moisture, I should say, around the state. And due to that, once we get to the middle of the afternoon, we're going to start seeing a lot of rain from this system. It's not a depression, not even a storm, or a tropical storm anyway. It's just a tropical wave with tropical moisture. So that's part of the reason, A, we're feeling a lot muggier, and that's also why around 3, 4, 5 o'clock, we'll start to see a lot of flare-ups in the area going into the evening as well, and then the rainfall will fizzle out. So that's your tropic.
Yeah, I'm CBS 4 meteorologist Seth Gonzalez with your tropics update, and we are watching two areas. The remnants of what once was Harvey in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico right now. This area of showers, thunderstorms has become better organized, strengthening, and in fact, the Hurricane Center says it has 100% chance of redeveloping either back into a depression, a tropical storm, possibly even a hurricane as it moves west-northwest towards the Gulf Coast. Right now, it's likely that we'll see landfall of some system, whether it's just a tropical wave, or right now models are pointing that it could again strengthen as we get into Friday. And we're going to see the impacts not only through Texas, but also into Louisiana with devastating flooding possible there. For us, we have this area of low pressure that we've been tracking all week long. It's draped across Florida, through the Bahamas, and into the western Atlantic. And this disorganized area of showers and thunderstorms has a low potential of development over the next 5 days, a 30% chance. Really, as we take a look at this system, it is going to bring us some heavy rain and flooding even through the rest of the week. So here's a look at the computer models for the remnants of Harvey, which is forecast again to strengthen as it moves generally towards the west and northwest. Right now, we'll be bringing torrential rain, hurricane force winds possible along the Texas-Louisiana coast. But right now, we're seeing a potential landfall around Corpus Christi, Houston, as we get into late Friday. And through the weekend, it just lingers there. So here's the deal for us. We have plenty of moisture associated with not only the remnants of Harvey and whatever Harvey becomes headed towards Texas and Louisiana, but then stretching across the Gulf and across the state of Florida, plenty of moisture as well associated with that area of low pressure that's just going to linger. So that means stormy tropical downpours will be possible for much of the state of Florida. And here in South Florida, again, we could see some flooding through Friday. Make sure to stay tuned to CBS 4 and right here at CBSMiami.com. We'll have your latest updates.